First of all, I would like to thank the ODI for inviting me to this distinguished event. The other thank is to the DFID for approaching our ministry to be included in this assessment. Special thanks to the team of researchers, Nicola, Dr. Mohammed, and Dr. Bassam. Thank you very much all. Indeed, this is a very interesting assessment for the Ministry of Social Affairs, and frankly, it's the first qualitative assessment. All the time, and all the our partners were conducting quantitative assessments, and all the time we are dealing with figures, percentages, diagrams, circles, triangles. This is the first time we are dealing with our people. This is the first time we are listening to our beneficiaries and non-beneficiaries, to our community. And frankly, we got a lot of certificates that our program is the best in the region. If my people don't say this for me, this is the problem. In the eyes of my people, the credibility of my program is the most important. We got a certificate from the World Bank in the first assessment. I think only Chile is better than us in the accuracy of targeting all over the world. This is important for me if I convince my people and listen this from my people. This is why such assessment was the most interesting. And if we are to work on the recommendations, either in the short run or in the long run, I think this assessment will shape our thinking in the coming years, not only now for this event or after or for the dissemination. Such assessments raise the voice of the voiceless. Frankly, this is what happened, and we were shocked. Not because of the bad, the negative assessment, that we listen to our people. They help us in even defining poverty. How do they perceive poverty? And you know, we have a lot of donors. We have a lot of schools in Palestine. And we have these best practices all over the world. What is poverty? It is the $1 per day or the $2 or the economic perspective or the social perspective. But when we listen to the people in the assessment and put ourselves in their place, frankly, we understand poverty and vulnerability more. The other important lesson from this assessment is the multidimensionality of poverty. All the time we are providing people with cash. This program takes 50% of the budget of my ministry. 50% without the running cost, the direct benefit to the people. All the social transfers, cash, health insurance, education fees, and all of these things, takes 90% of my budget in the ministry. This means all the other costs and expenditures are 10%. This is very good for me, because I can tell you that we are managing all of our social protection interventions efficiently and effectively. The running cost is around 10% with the salaries, all the cost. And 90% of the cost goes directly to direct benefit to our people. The multidimensionality of poverty and vulnerability, because in Palestine we are working on a social protection strategy, cash intervention is not enough, and it should not be a segregated intervention. This is why we are trying to learn lessons from such an assessment, how when we are mapping out or designing our social protection strategy and interventions to tackle not a single dimension of poverty, which is the give the families the cash. From our point of view, what we are trying to do after the assessment, at least in the coming direct period, we will focus on three things: monitoring and evaluation. We are doing some kind of monitoring and evaluation here and there. But what we are looking for when we are talking about strategies and building systems, We are in bad need for developing a monitoring and evaluation system, not only for this program, which is the cash transfer program, but for all of what I'm doing to my people, which are the social protection interventions. Social accountability, after this assessment again, we strongly believe in social accountability, but when we listen and hear to the sayings of our people, we should work in the coming period on enforcing social accountability and feedback channels and bring people not only to tell me how do they evaluate the benefit. They may participate in designing the interventions from the first moment. The other one is the governance of the program, and this is what we are trying to do at the central level and at the local level. And part of it will be the complaint system and the transparency and the even the communication and the outreach to our people. You talked about the acknowledgement of the people regarding what's the government doing, and this is normal in Palestine because donors are working in a higher profile than the national government. But they are stronger in communication and they are communicating every payment in their own style and these beautiful posters. And it was stuck in the mind of my people that who is paying for them is the donors. And here it's again a unique opportunity to acknowledge the contribution of the EU and the World Bank in contributing to the social protection interventions. But now what's new in Palestine that the EU, the World Bank, and all the donors are aligning with my national strategy and national priorities, because I have a social protection strategy. It's not a donor-driven project. Yani cash transfer program is not only a funded project. Now it's the hardcore program within my own strategy on social protection. What we have started doing after the assessment, my colleagues, I think they finalized within 2 days the first draft of the operation manual. We have an old one, but we took all the recommendations and all the complaints that we received from our beneficiaries, and we worked on updating the operation manual to make it more transparent, more easy, and even to my social workers to have this kind of unified methodology and procedures and operations. So this will be published, I think, in May. This is a very direct one. On the other regard, we are working with our partners to develop the institutional arrangements. It's not enough to invite other ministries who are under social protection to central meetings where the ministers speak and shake hands and go. We are trying to set institutional base for this relationship, and how could we together agree on an action plan to implement the cross-cutting issues. And since the social protection is a cross-cutting issue, as horizontal, we started signing MOUs in detailed articles to agree upon what should we do, Ministry of Education, Ministry of Health, or Ministry of Social Affairs. What we are trying to do in the coming 3 years is to do this with our NGOs and local partners, CSOs and NGOs, in delivering the social services system. Now we are in the process of discussions on the scenarios how to amend or modify the benefit scale, taking into consideration the recommendations and the multidimensionality of the poverty. We should tackle the need and the requests and demands of disability, elderly, children, and the chronically ill persons within the families. And we started with the World Food Program to develop the log frame for all the social protection interventions. Now we have it, frankly, for the cash. But we'll do it for all the interventions of the ministry. And what's interesting is that we should develop the log frame not only for the ministry, all the interventions, even though they are cross-cutting with our partners and other ministries and agencies. And one of the interesting also results of the assessment, and frankly we have it in mind, that the social workers feel themselves, because of the heavy burden to update the data for the cash, that they are data collectors and data surveyors. They are not social workers. This is why the focus will be in the coming 3 years to develop a social services system and develop needs-driven social services instead of the current one, which is supply-driven services, and the capacity building for the social worker refreshment, and to enable them to work on case management, to discover what the family needs, rather than the easiest thing is to give the household cash, and the difficult thing is to enable her to exit from the cash. But we are talking about case management and social services. We discovered this disability, elderly, victimized women inside the family, abused children, without voiceless. No one knows because of the secrecy within the family. This is the role of the social worker. And then with our local partners, they have to develop a referral system and to channel them according to this intervention. This will be done by Minister of Social Affairs, the other by Minister of Health, or by NGOs who are strongly working in the field. And we are working in the coming 3 years on mapping out the social services structure in Palestine. We have a lot of social services providers in Palestine, but we will make it more clear to all the people, first of all, and then to the service providers, because this is the infrastructure if I'm talking about governance, monitoring, evaluation, accountability, and referral systems agreed upon between the partners. And the cross-cutting issues also, which needs to be mainstreamed, or we are working on gender and disability. We have a national strategy for gender in Palestine, and we recently developed a strategic national framework in Palestine for disability. And the main goal of such strategies is mainstreaming. The key word is mainstreaming, dealing with the disability within Ministry of Social Affairs alone, within Ministry of Health alone, within Ministry of Education alone, it will not give us what we are looking forward as inclusive social protection approach. And for the feedback channels with grievance procedures, we started after the assessment, we agreed upon launching the what we will call the beneficiaries forums. And we'll organize it on the local level and make it systematic with a consolidated mechanism. It's not only we want you to come once a year and make this workshop and publish the results. It should be systematic, and we will make it in all the governorates in Palestine. And they will have the chance to raise their voice on the programs, first of all, themselves, then on the procedures and the benefit, and the inclusion and exclusion errors and all the details. The outcomes of this assessment directly affects what we are doing now, starting the last month, on updating the social protection strategy. The planning cycle in Palestine ended in 2013. The last one, 2011-2013. Now the social protection coming strategies, 2014-2016. The ultimate goal for such strategy is to maintain the social cohesion of the Palestinian society. And this is the very important thing, taking into consideration that we are talking about developing system for social protection. We should not forget how complex it is, as how difficult. And we are talking about people living under direct Israeli military occupation, which is the direct threat to social protection and to protection itself. And sometimes our people say, you are talking fantasy. What are you doing? No, we are doing our duty because we are a duty bearer here. We should support our people, the social fabrics and the social cohesion. And we should respond to their needs and rights. And now, all the strategies, mainly the social protection, are rights-based approach. I know that this is very expensive when we are trying about budgeting, but at least when you trying to incorporate the concept and the policy level on the program level and on the implementation level and on the awareness, I think we are proceeding in this regard. The new strategy highlighting the three priorities to tackle: poverty, vulnerability, and social exclusion. Most of our effort, frankly, in the past was on poverty. We didn't work a lot on social exclusion. We didn't tackle the issue of vulnerability. Now we have this kind of linkages between the three components. The social protection system will be built upon three subsystems: social assistance system, social services system, social security system. What we are doing now is scatter the programs and interventions. They are not systems. Cash alone is not the system. It's a very major intervention, but it should be the main pillar for the social assistance system. And the people should be channeled from the cash to non-cash interventions. If we are talking about developing an exit strategy for the people from the poverty cycle, our social protection system will be transformative, because we have to take into consideration that cash is a relief intervention. Whatever it has positive impacts on the human capital of the family and the individuals, it's a relief. It needs to be accompanied by economic empowerment, transformative activities, supporting the families to find the new jobs. The other one, it should be inclusive, taking into consideration that we are talking about social inclusion. And those who are excluded at the margin of the society needs to be catered for, not only for cash, even though their participation in the public life and public events is very essential as a human rights. The three B's of the coming social protection system will be prevention, protection, and promotion. And when we are talking about vulnerability, prevention here works very well, because even we are focusing on the poor and even on the extremely poor, we must keep an eye on those who are fragile or vulnerable to fall into the poverty cycle. And the developing synergies between the social protection interventions is one of the main priorities for the coming area. And the most important intervention is the graduation from poverty. If I'm keeping all my people on my payroll, this means that I'm failing. And my success is not having an inclusion and exclusion margin of error, or I'm catering for 570,000 individuals or 100,000 households. My concrete success, how many households I help them to exit from the poverty cycle. And we are not happy to keep our people waiting for cash assistance. They are entitled for a more decent life, and they should be part of the society on the political, on the social, and on the economic level. Thank you very much.
Thank you.